judge all by actions. Love's the only answer. And you are listening to 94.1 KPFA and 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, 97.5 K248BR in Santa Cruz, and online at kpfa.org. Right now, it's a minute past 1 p.m. Stay tuned for Project Censored.
Welcome, everybody, to the Project Censored show on Pacifica Radio. I'm Mickey Huff. Peter Phillips is taking a well-deserved day off, although he will be joining me as a guest briefly at the end of the show today. This is the last day of the KPFA fund drive, and we are very, very close to our goal. And my goal, coming down here from Sonoma County today, is to make the goal, get us over that hump, and we can't do it without you, the great listeners of community radio, free speech radio, KPFA. Again, this is the Project Censored show. I'm Mickey Huff, and we have a fantastic whirlwind show for you today, so it's going to be quick. Some of you may know that it's so quick that we jumped in without the theme music. So we are ready to raise money, and you can call 800-439-5732, 800-439-5732, or online at kpfa.org. I have something special for you today, folks. The brand new, hot, off-the-press, fresh-baked Project Censored book, Censored 2017, the 40th anniversary edition. My co-editor and associate director, Andy Lee Roth, and I finished it over the summer. It's got a dynamite foreword by the one and only Mark Crispin Miller, fantastic cartoons by Khalil Bandib, and we're offering it to you today on the Project Censored show for a $120 pledge. It's not even on the shelves yet. Be the first cool kid on your block to have a copy, a shiny copy. Censored 2017, $120 pledge. DVD of Project Censored, the movie, our award-winning film, $100. Bumper sticker and membership for KPFA, $25. I just want to get 10 people calling in right now and get this over with so we can get over the hump. That's how close we are here, folks, at Free Speech Radio. 800-439-5732 is the number to call. So let's get on to the content of today's program. On today's program, we are looking at Censored 2017, the 40th anniversary edition. Noam Chomsky says, "It is immensely gratifying to be able to congratulate Project Censored on the 40th anniversary of its remarkable achievements, both in bringing to us critically important stories that have had little or no media attention and in engaging young activists who will be able to carry on this very valuable work, a crucial contribution to the hope for a more just and democratic society." This is what Noam Chomsky says about Project Censored and our 40th anniversary edition, Censored 2017. And I am joined right now by my co-editor and my associate director at Project Censored, Andy Lee Roth. Andy, thanks so much for joining us today on the Project Censored show.
Hi, Mickey. It's great to be on the air with you.
So, Andy, you and I did a lot of work on this 450-page book, 10 chapters. Tell our listeners a little bit about, you know, what goes into our stories. Maybe talk a little bit about the process as educators. As you know, I read that Chomsky blurb a moment ago, right? And I think he rightfully notes that one of the things that Project Censored has done over the years that's maybe different than other media organizations is critical media literacy education. So talk to a little bit about that and about how we go through the stories.
Yeah, I mean, the top 25 list that is the first of, as you mentioned, 10 some chapters in this year's book, the determination of each year's top 25 stories is really a year-long process that involves literally hundreds of people, faculty and students from college and university campuses across the country and indeed around the world, and ultimately the participation of Project Censored's panel of expert judges, more than two dozen experts, media activists, media scholars, professional journalists who help us to vet the stories that we're looking at and considering for inclusion in the top 25 each year. So this year, to be a little more specific, the top 25 stories that feature in Censored 2017 were researched by some 221 students, 33 faculty members from 18 colleges and university campuses across the U.S. and in Canada. And we looked at this year to whittle down to the top 25. We identified and vetted and summarized some 235 stories from the independent press, what we call VINs, or validated independent news stories. And each of those 235 stories from which the top 25 were selected are posted up on the Project Censored website, and they are available to the public there as a resource.
And Andy, that's projectcensored.org. You can see the stories researched year-round. We have roughly 20 campuses, as you were rattling down the numbers there. There's, again, so much work goes into this 40-year project that was founded by Carl Jensen at Sonoma State University and carried on by Peter Phillips for so long, who's still contributing to the book every year. And, you know, you and I have done, I think, seven of these together. This would be my eighth, I think, total. And, Andy, let's talk a little bit, too, about some of the other things. Well, let's stick with the first chapter momentarily, since you were just talking about the validated independent news stories. And, you know, without going into detail, since this doesn't come out until October 4th, but what can you tell us maybe about the kinds of stories or a pattern of types of stories that are censored and underreported over the years that is a continuation into this year's volume?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I can say that some of the story topics touch on issues such as the global presence of U.S. military forces. This year, we talked some about the crisis of evidence-based medicine, links between climate change and gender inequality. But I want to step back from even that level of detail on the top 25 and talk about why it's important to put together a list, an annual list of stories that are underreported in the corporate media. And here this really goes to the issue of the idea that I think undergirds everything that we do at Project Censored, and it's certainly a informing theme in Censored 27, this year's book, which is the idea that media power is political power. And there are many ways that we could unpack the meaning of that term, or the meaning of that statement, and I want to just briefly touch on two of them. Media power is political power. One way is that the corporate media have played a crucial, perhaps unintentional role in diminishing the public's understanding of what it means to participate in a democratic society. As Ben Bagdikian, who we dedicated this year's volume to, noted back almost 30 years ago, most Americans have no longer experienced democracy on a daily basis in their lives. And that's a deep and profound problem. And I think one of the aims of producing a top 25 list, like we do in the book each year, is to better inform people so that they might engage with these issues in their daily lives. Now, a second way, if I could just very quickly come back to the idea of media power as political power, has to do with what we're doing when we produce the top 25 list, and that's engaging students directly in examining the content of the corporate news, comparing and contrasting it with what's available when we turn to independent news sources, and then educating the public about what they found when they do that. And so for those listeners who haven't seen the top 25 list before, it's important to note that in addition to crediting the journalists and the independent news outlets that broke these stories that make up our top 25 list, we also identify by name the student researcher and the faculty evaluator who did the vetting work to see, well, has this story been covered in the corporate press? And I think it's the hands-on engagement that the students get by working with and as the project is something that is, to our knowledge, I think completely distinctive about Project Censored as a media watchdog group, as one of the longest-standing media watchdog groups in the country.
And that's right, Andy. Andy Lee Roth, we're speaking to the associate director of Project Censored, my colleague and co-editor of Censored 2017, the 40th anniversary edition that's coming out soon. And you just heard Andy say one of the key things that we do at Project Censored is critical media literacy education, outreach to students and schools. And we think that this is a really big part of making people aware of the amount of censorship, propaganda, and disinformation that are going on in the corporate news media and corporate deep state messaging that take place in the United States, all under the guise or rubric of a free press or a protected free press. Well, Andy, you're going to stay on with us, but we have joining the program now, we have someone that is someone from the millennial generation, right, that gets a lot of disdain in the corporate media and among two major political candidates. And but I'd have to say our next guest is not only a stalwart independent journalist, but really the kind of reporting that she does is to quote one of the subtitles of our 2014 book, Andy, she's an exemplar of speaking, exemplifying it by fearless speech in fateful times. And our next guest is the founder of Mint Press News, and that would be Manar Mahawish. And she has a program called Behind the Headline. Her website is Mint Press News. Manar Mahawish, welcome to the program.
Thank you so much, Mickey, for having me, and thank you for the kind introduction. I appreciate that.
Well, Manar Mahawish, we at Project Censored, as you heard Andy Roth saying, not only do we point out censored stories and do we point out and criticize many of the problems that take place in media, right, but we also celebrate courageous independent journalists that are willing to go and tell the stories that we really need to know to understand what's happening around the world. And I'd have to say that, the stories that you cover at Mint Press News are so significant in terms of what they hit on that the corporate media either miss altogether or grossly distort, that, again, I can't say the word exemplar. This is the kind of reporting that we need in the United States and around the world today. And I'd like you to talk to us a little bit about what you do at Mint Press News. You have a story on Syria in our book this year, and you also have a segment in our Media Democracy in Action chapter on Mint Press News. Tell us about what you do, Manar Mahawish, and how people can find out more.
Well, thank you. I'm honored that, our work is being featured, but, Mint Press, was started. I started Mint Press for the exact reasons that you do Project Censored. I mean, we focus on how the media manipulates, they propagate, they provide so much disinformation to the public about issues that we should be highly informed about. And the reason I, pursued journalism in the first place is because I was a victim of this disinformation as a Palestinian American. My parents moved us overseas for 3.5 years, almost 4 years, to Jerusalem, and we lived under Israeli occupation and apartheid. And so I saw firsthand what U.S. foreign policy was doing to people overseas, and I saw that it was funding, a police state, an apartheid state, a militarized state like Israel. And so when I had come back to the United States, I saw the media provide so much disinformation about Palestinians, about Palestinian liberation, and they painted the picture. They basically flipped the narrative. And so from there, I was, about 12, 12 and a half, 13 years old. I had, even though I was so young, I had seen how the media specialized basically in flipping the narrative on most foreign policy issues. And so when it comes to, the war in Iraq, I was, very vocal in my high school speaking out against it. And so when this war in Syria came along, we were one of the first news organizations to stand up and say that the narrative that we were being basically fed about the crisis in Syria was not only disinformation, but our foreign policy was the one that had basically created this chaos inside Syria. And we were, our media was perpetuating this narrative so that we can justify more war. And so that's kind of the kind of work that we do. And something that we specifically specialize in is looking at how these special interests, how the military-industrial complex influences policies at home and abroad. So we like to say that we were the neocon watchdogs in our media.
So, Manar, tell people the website and a little bit about the program that you do.
So, you know, our website is mintpressnews.com, and we launched about 4 years ago. And, you know, most recently in the last year, we launched a video segment called Behind the Headline. And basically, it's just a video format of what we already do at Mint Press. But, you know, with the new age of journalism, you got to get on video. And so we added that to our reporting. And the show is actually supposed to launch this month on Free Speech TV. It'll be airing on Dish Network and on Roku. And basically what we're trying to do is we're trying to reach an audience that, you know, turn to the TV to get information. And unfortunately, even liberal media that's available on TV is not quite telling the truth about some of the most important stories, like the war on whistleblowers or the war on, you know, the truth about the money-making schemes of the war on terror. And so we wanted to be in the forefront of that, information and to basically dissect those narratives and to be able to reach people that are normally watching TV. And unfortunately, we do have a rise of the pseudo-liberal media. And we even want to challenge that. We have news stations, even like Democracy Now. I love Democracy Now. I love Amy Goodman. But we just have to be honest that sometimes even those news organizations do perpetuate those deep state narratives. I mean, I just saw the other day that they were celebrating the Libyan revolution on Twitter. And I thought, that was a CIA-backed revolution. And so sometimes even our liberal, so-called liberal media is perpetuating those kinds of narratives, maybe unknowingly. I'm not sure. And so we want to be able to challenge those kinds of narratives as well.
Manar Mahawish, Mint Press News, again, agreed here at Project Censored. We've sometimes gotten in hot water because we've also criticized colleagues on the left of the spectrum. But again, you know, I'd like to go back to the idea that we're not necessarily interested in tearing down. We're interested in building up. And if we can kind of call out this kind of reporting and call out where there might be disagreements, we can actually have a dialogue that a free press is supposed to really help generate in our robust democracy. So, Manar Mahawish, you will be joining us October 21st at the 40th anniversary celebration of Project Censored. You are going to be involved in a great roundtable discussion with Abby Martin from The Empire Files, with David Talbot, author of The Devil's Chessboard, and also Mark Crispin Miller, who did the foreword to our book this year. So we look forward to seeing you October 21st at Sonoma State University. People can find out more at projectcensored.org. Manar Mahawish, thank you for your work at Mint Press News, and thanks for joining us on the Project Censored show today.
Thank you so much, Mickey.
So Andy Lee Roth, there we have one of the contributors to the book this year in our Media Democracy in Action. And again, I was telling people that our publishers at Seven Stories Press in New York, they've been with us from the beginning of our book publishing. And our publisher, Dan Simon, wrote a very kind dedication and in support of us and the kind of work that we do here at Project Censored. So, but Andy, we're going to have to start looking and pitching for support for KPFA and Free Speech Radio here. But I wanted you to say another couple things, maybe wrap up. What are some of the highlights of the things that you think from the Censored 2017 book this year, or maybe some things that you're looking forward to for the 40th anniversary summit coming up October 21 and 2?
Yeah, thanks, Mickey. I mean, I think one thing I would point to as a kind of dynamic that I think is very important, and it works well with KPFA as the base for the Project Censored radio show. You mentioned Seven Stories Press, our publisher, and of course what we at Project Censored do. We're all, and Manar from Mint Press News, independent media. And the point I would make to kind of sign off, and I think this will be a theme at the 40th anniversary summit and celebration, is that independent media, one role of the independent media is to force our corporate counterparts to cover stories that they'd otherwise rather ignore or marginalize. And we've seen this time and again, and I think in the Project Censored yearbook over the years, the Deja Vu chapter that Susan Rahman will Dion later helps coordinate is testament to this. And I would just point to one, I think without letting too many cats out of bags. One of our stories this year is about the documentation of IP addresses from the New York Times, from the New York Police Department headquarters at One Police Plaza in New York. IP addresses there being tracked back to anonymously editing Wikipedia entries on police brutality. This is a story that was broken by Kelly Weil at Capital New York, which has since been renamed Political New York. But the reason I bring this up now is I think this story is an important in this way, this theme of independent media forcing corporate media to cover stories. There was subsequent coverage of that story, of the Wikipedia edits from these New York Police Department Internet Protocol IP addresses in the Washington Post and Time magazine. But I think the interesting question is, to what extent would there have been any corporate media coverage at all had there not been Kelly Weil at Capital New York breaking that story and the people at Capital New York doing the deep investigative research necessary to bring that story forward and to document it so thoroughly. And so I think this is another area where if you think of this theme as media power is political power, part of the power of independent media is to help reset the frame that is otherwise dominated and controlled by corporate entities. And so that theme is, I think, a recurrent thread through the Censored 2017 book. And as I say, I think that is a theme that will be coming up again and again next month at the Media Freedom Summit and 40th year 40th anniversary celebration.
Well, Andy Lee Roth, thank you so much for not only all the work that you've done with me and with the project over the years. Thanks so much for joining the program today. And also thank you, too, for calling out Ben Bigdikian, to whom we dedicated the book this year, the late, great Ben Bigdikian of Media Monopoly, formerly at UC Berkeley School of Journalism, towering figure that we still learn from, and we dedicate the 40th anniversary book to Ben Bigdikian. Andy Lee Roth, thank you for joining us on the Project Censored Show today.
Thanks so much, Mickey.
Well, it's now time to ask you to pledge your support for Free Speech Radio. And like I said in the introduction, be the first person on your block to have this new book that we're talking about with Andy Lee Roth, myself, with Manar Mahawash. Manar Mahawash contributed a chapter in the book. It's called Media Democracy in Action, where we have a compilation of some of the people that we think are doing some of just the best independent journalism. And that's what we celebrated Project Censored. And lo and behold, that's also what KPFA does at Free Speech Radio. And we need you to call in 800-439-5732. We're very close to meeting the fall fund drive goal, people. And we need people power. And the kind of people power we need right now at Free Speech Radio is for you to call in 800-439-5732. You can get the brand new Censored 2017 40th Anniversary Edition for a $120 pledge. You can get the DVD, Project Censored the Movie, Ending the Reign of Junk Food News for $100. You can become a member of KPFA for $25 and get a Project Censored bumper sticker. So when you're driving around or not just stuck in traffic but are traffic, people can read that and say, oh, the news that didn't make the news. I wonder what that is. And on one side of your car, you have the KPFA bumper sticker and on another, Project Censored. 800-439-5732 is the number to call. And yes, this is the Project Censored show. And yes, these are Project Censored premiums. And no, we are not profiting from these premiums. And I want to make sure that there's full disclosure that we offer these materials to KPFA at cost. We do not profit from our own items through KPFA. Just like Peter Phillips and I, my co-host, who's going to join us later to talk about his chapter, we come down here from Sonoma County as volunteers in support of community radio because this is what we believe it means not only to be part of this kind of community, but as professors and academics and public intellectuals, we believe that these are the kinds of things that we are supposed to do to contribute to our democratic culture. Please call 800-439-5732. Please show your support not only for this kind of programming, but please support KPFA Free Speech Radio, Pacifica, You know, this program is on 35 stations around the U.S., but we do it right here. We come to Berkeley, California, home of the free speech movement, home of community radio, started here after World War II. Please call in 800-439-5732. That's the number to call. You heard Andy Lee Roth talking about what's in the 2017 book. Be the first to have it. 800-439-5732 for a $120 pledge. $10 a month, people. $10 a month. I don't even think you can get two draft beers or lattes. $10 a month gets you this book, Censored 2017 40th Anniversary Edition, and keeps things going here at KPFA. This is your radio station. $100 gets you the DVD, Project Censored, the movie, award-winning, I might add, Ending the Reign of Junk Food News. You can get a bumper sticker and become a member of KPFA for $25. We're going to have some other people on the show talking about the contents of this book, folks. And Manar Mahawish from Mint Press News, whom you just heard, she contributed to a chapter that includes Peter B. Collins from the Peter B. Collins Show. Also in the Bay Area, Peter B. Collins has one of the best news and analysis shows going. If you don't know Peter B. Collins, check him out in Chapter 4. Check him out online. We've got the one and only Eric Dratzer from StopImperialism.org. Abby Martin has a contribution from the Empire Files, who used to be on Breaking the Set and does Media Roots with her brother, the filmmaker Robbie Martin. Fantastic work. This is just in one chapter, folks. Darcy Rakestraw from Food and Water Watch, whom I got to meet in D.C., Washington, D.C., when I was speaking at Ralph Nader's Breaking Through Power Tour. By the way, Ralph Nader's coming to Berkeley. I'll be hosting him with KPFA and Project Censored October 17th. Another way you can support KPFA. We've also got our next guest that's going to be coming on, Susan Rahman. She has several contributions. She has a contribution on service learning, and that attaches to critical media literacy, very important educational work that you heard Andy Lee Roth talking about. This is what Project Censored's about. We're not just about calling out the censored stories and calling out propaganda. We're also about supporting independent journalism and supporting places like KPFA with our volunteer efforts. And we're about education. We are about teaching the next generation how to speak truth to power. And we would like you to show how you can share in that effort by calling in 800-439-5732. We're very close to the goal. We would very much like to get over that hump during this hour. I would love to be able to go out into the lobby and find out that the Project Censored Show helped get us over that figure. And I would also be very happy to bring a boxload of books down here to KPFA so they can start sending these out to you immediately. As soon as the fund drive's over, you can get Censored 2017 40th Anniversary Edition. Doesn't come out till October 4, but you can have a copy first by supporting us here, supporting the Project Censored Show, and supporting KPFA.org. 800-439-5732. 800-439-5732 is the number to call. KPFA.org. You can go online. You can select this premium. Please help us get over the goal. Coming up, we're going to be speaking with Professor Susan Rahman, who has been a longtime contributor to Project Censored. She is a professor at College of Marin. We've worked with Susan for years. She's on the board with us at Media Freedom Foundation. I have had the distinct pleasure not only of working with Susan, but her amazing students. And she's going to come on air here momentarily and talk to us about what she does, with her students. She'll talk a little bit about service learning. And after that, we're going to go to San Francisco State University professor Ken Burrows, who's a longtime contributor to Project Censored, also on the board at Media Freedom Foundation, with a student, Brandy Maselli, who has done great work with us and has some great research on what's called generative journalism. They're going to talk about that. And then we'll round out the show with Peter Phillips talking about public relations propaganda firms in service to transnational capitalist class worldwide. Cutting-edge research in the new Project Censored book. 800-439-5732 is the number to call. I'd like to remind you all, you are listening to the Project Censored Show on Pacifica Radio. I'm Mickey Huff. the host of this program with Peter Phillips. Again, it's an honor to be part of the KPFA and Pacifica family. And I'd like to thank all of you that have supported KPFA during this fund drive. Please keep the support coming in today. Please keep it coming in this hour so we can make our goals. 800-439-5732. Up next, I'm speaking with Professor Susan Rahman. I mentioned to you just a moment ago that she has a fantastic contribution to Media Democracy in Action chapter on service learning and education. She also, for the last couple of books, though, has been doing our chapter two with her students called Deja Vu, Censored Deja Vu, which goes back and looks at previously undercovered and censored stories and tries to find out what has happened with those stories. And this year it's called Censored Deja Vu, Strolling Down Memory Hole Lane, where we go down and look at some of the top stories over 40 years and where are they today. But let's welcome Susan Rahman to the Project Censored show, and let's talk about some of the things that Susan Rahman does with us at Project Censored. Susan, welcome to the Project Censored show.
Oh, thanks, Mickey. It's great to be here.
I'm really excited to have you on because every time you talk to me about what's happening with your students and in the classroom, I can't help but get excited with you and for you. Talk to us a little bit about what's happening in your classroom and with students and why you're doing this work.
Oh, sure. Thanks. Well, I love being a teacher, and I came to Project Censored a few years ago just through kind of luck of bumping into Peter up in Sonoma County. And I've been, you know, enjoying having the students go through the, you know, media literacy process of hunting down independent stories and finding things that they otherwise wouldn't find, and watching students kind of morph into activists in a lot of ways because they're learning about things that they never would have seen otherwise and then just becoming really fired up. And, you know, it's been an exciting, really exciting part of my job, best part of my job, is having students be interested in seeking out change. And so I do a lot of work with the Social Justice Club. I run that club with the students, and we work together on different causes. We've done a lot of pretty neat things in response to stories that they've learned about on the Project Censored pathway, doing the stories, doing VINs, doing all of that. They've come across issues that have made them really angry. And so so one of the things that we're really trying to do is get the bookstore at our college to stop selling slave labor clothing and join what's called the Workers' Rights Consortium. And so that came about after a story that we learned about the Bangladesh factory collapse in 2013, and that kind of was the impetus for change for those guys. And it's just kind of been a growing thing. And, you know, this idea of civic engagement in the classroom and taking it out into, you know, the local and the broader society has been something that I try to wrap my teaching around just because I feel like it's, you know, putting theory to practice. And, yeah, I mean, I'm excited. Yes, I'm excited. And I'm really excited to get the book. I just got it a half an hour ago, so I am one of the cool kids on the block, and I think everyone else should get one, too.
Indeed, and you're co-author of this piece, Socially Just Pathways to Inclusivity via Service Learning and Universal Design. And your co-author is Eliana Demopoulos?
Eliana Demopoulos, yes. She's a colleague of mine at the College of Marin, and she's highly trained in universal design, and she does student accessibility services, and so that's kind of her niche, and she's got a lot of great ideas, and we're trying to build this all out. You know, I mean, you also work at community college, and so you understand that it takes a bit of time to get things through the pipe, but these are things that, you know, after they're done, then everybody has a different experience with the community college pathway. And so it's one of the things that we think is going to be a really, really nice change to the college. And the same goes with service learning. We're building out the service learning program, and more students are having the opportunity to go into places and do service learning type work and then reflect back on it, you know, through the theory of the practice. So one of the things we do is Project Censored. My students do a lot of work for Project Censored, and They help with the book. They do different speaking events. You've had Caitlin McCoy. You've had Bree Silva. You've had Nathan Bowman. I had to name drop, sorry.
Maya McHugh.
Maya McHugh. Yeah, so that has been, you know, and as you know, it's sort of addictive, Project Censored. They don't really leave, which is, you know, great because we're, you know, people are becoming, like, engaged on a level that, you know, will last, I think, more so than some things you just get in a classroom, you know, then you're done.
It's so true, Susan Rahman. And I know you're working on social justice issues, community engagement, service learning at College of Marin. I'm proud to say that I'm doing similar things with my colleagues at Diablo Valley College, where I teach and co-chair the history department and work in the social science department. We're working on a social justice degree and major. And again, I think that this is what brings people alive, and this is really the purpose of education in a democratic republic, is to really turn people on to what's happening, get people understanding the significance of civic engagement, and, you know, education is a great public arena in which to do this, and we don't need to cede the educational arena to private forces and corporate profits. This is the antithesis to that. This is the grassroots kind of education that people really need, and Susan Rahman, you're one of the people on the front lines of that. And, you know, like you said, your students get turned on. Sometimes they get angry, but then that anger leads to productive action. Knowledge is power, and then they go and try to change things to create a more just world. And it's an honor to work with you at the project, and I can't thank you enough for all of your contributions and the time you spend with your students.
Thank you. The feeling is mutual. It's amazing. I feel honored to be a part of it.
So, Susan Rahman, we will see you, too, at the Media Freedom Summit, October 21 and 22 at Sonoma State University. You'll be participating there with us and your students. By the way, students are free to the Media Freedom Summit, so spread the word and contact us through projectcensored.org. Susan Rahman, thanks for taking time out of your day to talk to us today, and thanks for being one of the cool kids that just got your new book. I'll let you go read it now.
Thank you.
Thank you, Susan.
Care.
Up next on the Project Censored Show, we have a student from San Francisco State University, Brandy Maselli, who we've been working with now for the past year, and I've had the pleasure of working with Brandy, and a professor, longtime contributor, Media Freedom Board member, Ken Burrows. And, you know, if you heard what I was just saying about the work that Susan Rahman does, just carbon copy it. Because this is the same quality, caliber, and kind of work that Ken Burrows does at San Francisco State University, and the kind of student Susan Rahman was just talking about. This is the student that Brandy Maselli is, and many of Ken's other students. They do the fine work that we celebrate at Project Censored, and it's an honor to have you all on the show today. Brandy Maselli, talk to us a little bit about some of the stories that you have going on in the book this year, especially generative journalism. Talk to us a little bit.
Sure. Thanks for having me, Mickey. It's so, so good to be a part of this. I wrote a story for Project Censored on a concept that we've been toying around with at San Francisco State called generative journalism. And generative journalism, what I've found is that communities have all they need to fulfill their aspirations, and all we need to do is ask the right questions, and people are ready to share their stories. I think that this type of journalism can actually open up an emerging future, the future that wants to be born. So it's a really exciting time, and I think that people are ready to hear it.
Indeed they are, Brandy Maselli, and people can learn more about that by picking up a copy of Censored 2017, 40th Anniversary Edition. And when I say pick up a copy, I mean pick up the phone and call 800-439-5732, 800-439-5732, because for a $120 pledge, you can get a copy of this book. And we're talking today, and we're just highlighting, we're just really breezing through these 450 pages with some of the wonderful contributors and educators and students and independent journalists. And I want to bring on Ken Burrows here, one of the professors that works with us at San Francisco State University. Ken Burrows,
yes.
Building on what Brandy was saying, we're obviously going to do a longer show in a few weeks with you and your work and Brandy and others. But give us a quick snapshot about what you're working on, because it's so really important and positive.
Well, thank you, Mickey. We at San Francisco State, as one affiliate, we feel we have a unique focus, and that many of the stories that my students find are, I think it has something to do with our studies in health education and holistic health. And we focus on constructive news, the kind of news that underlies the importance of staying open to human goodness and possibilities, and not just the constant ramping up of news. In fact, most news tends to be about what we fear. It's about natural disasters, human failures, murder, fraud, and so on. And naturally, these possible threats to human existence are important to pay attention to, and has a lot to do with the study of what we call the negativity bias, which is a biological theory about how humans evolved to be fearful to keep our ancestors alive. And yet, at the same time, we evolved a system to approach rewards as well as avoid hazards. Both are important, and for survival reasons, we clearly have to pay attention to negative stimuli, and that's what our news is more and more about. But unfortunately, we're leaving out this, we're over-reporting often the problems, and we're under-reporting human goodness and possibility. And so many of our stories about collaborative realities, about co-creativity, about the very essence of what we're calling constructive media literacy as a flip side of the coin of critical media literacy. How do we start to develop a constructive media that really, and we have four cornerstones to that I can mention a little bit more about if there's time, but how do we develop a media that also really brings in and highlights human goodness and possibility and partnership? You can see it really lacking in our culture right now.
So, Brandy Maselli, let's bring you back in and build a little bit on what Ken Burrows was saying and the kind of work you do. I know you work with the paper at San Francisco State University. You work with us at the project and also another nonprofit. And so talk about some of these experiences you're having.
Sure. So it's a really interesting time to be going into the journalism profession, and I've been studying journalism for the past 4 years. And recently, I've noticed a shift in the way that people view the media. And at times, it can be sort of disappointing because I feel that the media has let people down in some ways. And I think that generative journalism can really speak to this crisis. I think that highlighting human goodness and the creativity, the way people support each other in the world, it can really help motivate this shift. And it begs the question, you know, how do we aliven what's already there? I've been a part of contributing to the media in this way, and it's extremely rewarding. The results are tenfold.
Ken Burrows, let's go back to you. We have about a couple minutes left here just in this segment. We're only doing highlights from the book today as we're trying to we're trying to raise money for Free Speech Radio. We're trying to spread awareness, and we're trying to share these wonderful ideas with people. And we're doing it on the people's airways, but we're also doing it in this book that we do every year by Seven Stories Press and online at projectcensored.org. So, Ken, in the next couple minutes, run down a little bit of that list you were mentioning.
Well, you bet. Again, this is something really new. In fact, most news is not new. It's sort of a rehashing of past problems in new disguise. But creative news is really, we offer news that's really new. That's what I love about this whole idea about creative media and creative media literacy. It's about really new thought media, you might call it. So we have four cornerstones of this idea of constructive or this movement of constructive media. One that's fairly popular right now, it's gaining more traction, the solution-based news, about news that really, you know, answers many of the problems that are on the horizon. But it's still problem-based. To have a solution, you're still focused on problems, which is very different than civic engagement, collaboration, and often out of that, things emerge you haven't thought of, including solutions. So we have solution-based news as the first of the cornerstones. The generative journalism for community engagement and civic action that Brandy was talking about. And then validated health information networks that can be really useful for public health in other ways. And then mindful, balanced use of media itself. So we'll be focusing more on these in the summit. And we're very excited about this. This is something that we think will make a great difference to Project Censored and media reform in general.
Well, Ken Burrows, we'll leave it at that for now. But yes, indeed, we will see you and Brandy Maselli and others at the Project Censored 40th Anniversary Celebration at the Media Freedom Summit. This is October 21 and 22. We've got a stellar list of participants, and this is a contributive environment. It's not a being talked at conference. It's an unconference where we're building, and we're hopefully working toward really creating systemic changes here. And again, we're very happy to have you involved and in the book again, Brandy Maselli and Ken Burrows. Thanks a lot, and I will see you all next Wednesday when I'm speaking at San Francisco State University.
That's right, Vicki. We're looking forward to having you there.
Thanks, Brandy. Thanks, Ken.
You bet.
So this is the Project Censored Show, and we're in the last day of the fun drive, and you'll hear we're talking about the contents of a brand new book. It's our brand new book. It's Censored 2017, the 40th Anniversary Edition, and you know, we're really getting excited about this, and we're really caught up in the contents of the book, and we have so many more programs to do around the contributors to the book. But we'd like you to get a copy of this book before it comes out, and we'd like you to do that by calling 800-439-5732. Again, I've been in here caught up, just really excited about this project and the book that I'm part of. It's an honor to be part of that. It's an honor to be part of KPFA, Free Speech Radio. But I don't know how many people are calling in or what's happening. And it's wonderful when I go out in public and do speaking events and people come up to me and say, ah, I recognize your voice and now I've seen your face. It's nice to know people are out there listening. But show me you're listening now by calling in 800-439-5732. $120 gets you Censored 2017. 40th Anniversary Edition. Project Censored, the movie ending the reign of junk food news. Award-winning DVD, $100. Perfect for the classroom at an hour long. And Project Censored bumper sticker gets you membership at KPFA. That's a $25 pledge. We're going to continue the program today with my co-host, Peter Phillips, who has a contribution to the book this year, as always. This year, Peter has contributed really some groundbreaking research, some groundbreaking work, I have to say. His chapter is Selling Empire, War, and Capitalism, Public Relations Propaganda Firms in Service to the Transnational Capitalist Class. Peter, you join us by phone.
Yeah, hi, Mickey. The show's sounding great. This is chapter 7 in this book, and we started almost 9 months ago. And it was myself and four students here at Sonoma State, Raytona Coffey, Bobby Ramirez, Mary Schaefer, and Nicole Tranchina. They each took on a top public relations firm in the world. And the three biggest are Omnicom, WPP, and Interpublic Group. And what they did is they spent hours of time searching all of their, each of these companies' websites. Well, they have hundreds of independent subsidiaries all over the world. So these are companies that have been bought up by these big three PR firms. So we searched their websites, and we built, probably for the first time ever, a list of their clients. So we look at these three big firms. It's quite amazing. They have 200,000 employees every country in the world, literally, and $35 billion in revenue. They work for governments, corporations, and nonprofits all over the world. And we, you know, this is the first time a database like this has been built. And the students here and I spent many, many hours putting this together. But what we're saying here is that these big PR firms are the content providers for corporate media. 80%, up to 80% of the content in television news or newspapers comes from one of these big PR firms. So they are the news managers for the world. And Omnicom, you know, they do business with the city of Brooklyn, California Housing Authority, the California Lottery, the city of Chicago, China, Colombia, the Congo, Dubai, Ecuador, Egypt, you know, all over the world, Miami-Dade, the New York Police Department, New Zealand, Nicaragua. I mean, they are the ones marketing capitalism worldwide. They work for nonprofits like, you know, the Ad Council and American Red Cross and campaign for tourism in Canada. I mean, just amazingly, it's a private, you know, colleges, Cornell, K-12, Council of Foreign Relations, the dairy industry, the Governors Association, just massive amounts. And then we look at they're not only selling ideas and propaganda, but then they're also selling products. So this Omnicom alone, you know, they do 3M, 7-Up, Alaska Airlines, Bank of America, everything you could possibly think of, cigarettes, booze, beer, coffee, Mercedes-Benz, Morgan Stanley, Motorola. I mean, it took several pages to list all of these. Jack Daniels.
It sure did take a lot of pages.
But when people see it, they just go, "Oh my God, I had no idea." This is top-down managed news.
And not to mention that you call this out, and there's not only is there a chapter on CIA media manipulation in the book by Brian Covert, you get into that in the chapter, talking about Covert Action Quarterly that says former CIA official Robert Crowley, the agency's longtime liaison with corporations, acknowledged that Hill and Knowlton's overseas offices were perfect cover for the ever-expanding CIA. Unlike other cover jobs, being a public relations specialist did not require tactical training for CIA officers.
That's right. I mean, they are part of WPP, which is the second largest corporation in the world that's doing PR and propaganda. Hill and Knowlton were the ones that brought us the incubator baby story that kicked off the first invasion of Iraq.
Right.
After it was just an overt lie. And so they are part of, they brag on their website that they service half of the largest 500 corporations in the world.
Well, the CIA admitted that it used Hill and Knowlton overseas, and they have a small Washington office, right? Employees at a small Washington office and elsewhere distributed this kind of material through CIA assets working in the U.S. news media, the Mighty Wurlitzer, Mockingbird programs. And in fact, this is a quote from Johann Carlyle at the Covert Action Quarterly. Since the CIA is prohibited from disseminating propaganda inside the U.S., this type of blowback, which former CIA officer John Stockwell and other researchers have often traced to the agency, is illegal. And while the use of U.S. media by the CIA has a long and well-documented history, the covert involvement of PR firms may be news to many. And you write that in your chapter, Chapter 7, in the brand-new book, Censored 2017. Your chapter, Peter, is titled Selling Empire, War, and Capitalism, Public Relations Propaganda Firms in Service to the Transnational Capitalist Class. This is amazing work, and I think everybody needs to hear this kind of information and see this kind of information. This is what the news media should cover. This is what a free press does. They cover this kind of work, and this is what we do at Project Censored. This is what we do on the Project Censored show. Peter Phillips and I are going on close to 6 years this winter, and we'd love it if you could call in and support right now. Peter is going to stay on the line with me for the next 8 minutes because we need you to call 800-439-5732 to get this new book, Censored 2017, 40th Anniversary Edition. Today, we've just been doing a whirlwind overview of some of the things that are in the 450 pages from Seven Stories Press. $120 gets you Censored 2017. You support Free Speech Radio. We make our fundraising goal. $100 gets you the award-winning DVD, Project Censored the Movie, Ending the Reign of Junk Food News. $25, you become a member of KPFA, which is very important, your community radio station, and you get a Project Censored bumper sticker. 800-439-5732 is the number to call. Peter, why else should people be calling in to get this book?
Well, KPFA is the voice for public information, for people to know about progressive political issues in the world. I mean, this is not top-down news. This is bottom-up news. This is finding out what the powerful are doing. And that's exactly what the Censored 2017 book is about, and all the books that we've produced over the last 40 years. I mean, that's amazing stuff coming from a university saying this is who the powerful are. And people look at this 400-page book and they go, oh, that's a big book. I don't know if I have time to read that. Well, this is the kind of book that you sit on your coffee table and you read one story at a time. literally, and just think about it, because it's so impacting. It's so full of information. And you can have one right now, Censored 2017, 40th anniversary edition of Project Censored, by calling 1-800-439-5732. You could do that 1-800-HEY-KPFA or online at kpfa.org. We've been doing a lot online for this fund drive. And I think that we're going to be the ones that put us over the top here at KPFA.
I certainly hope you're right about that, Peter. We're really proud if we were able to do that. Just very quickly, you know, while you're dialing 800-439-5732 to get this Censored 2017 book, which, by the way, we don't profit from any of the things that we have here that we move through KPFA. These are all things that are at cost, and Peter and I are volunteers here, so we definitely want full disclosure so people understand that. 800-439-5732 is the number to call. Chapter 1 is the top 25. Chapter 2, Deja Vu. What's happened to previous stories? This year, Nolan Hagedon and his crew of students have put together a great timely chapter on the corporate media's war on reality, faux elections, and the facade of democracy. It's specific on the primaries. It's very timely to get this out in this book. Media Democracy in Action. We've got a great chapter by Susan Merritt, Contested Visions, Imperfect Information, and the Persistence of Conspiracy Theory, what it is, why they happen, how you can understand accuracy and fact-checking in them. Brian Covert, Played by the Mighty Wurlitzer, The Press, the CIA, and the Subversion of Truth. That's all in Censored 2017. Peter's chapter on public relations propaganda firms. Elliot Cohen, Remote Control, Electronic Surveillance, and the Demise of Human Dignity. Shahid Batar, Ike's Dystopian Dream and How It Came True on Surveillance, in a great finale chapter by Bill Usman, who we partner with at Sacred Heart University Graduate School and the Global Critical Media Literacy Project. He has a great chapter on Who's Afraid of Critical Media Literacy? What is it? And why do we need it? And you can get all of that information. It's just, this book is chock full of this kind of information that you need to be a more informed citizen here. And this is an election year, and this book is full of information that you heard Peter Phillips telling you. You can read it a little bit at a time. It exposes problems. It offers solutions. 800-439-5732. That's the number to call. 800-439-5732. Please put us over the edge here in a good way. Put us over the edge, 800-439-5732, so we can say that we made it to the KPFA Fund Drive goal. And for $120, you get Censored 2017. $100, you get our DVD. $25 gets you a bumper sticker. But most importantly, you're supporting this kind of programming. Peter and I are really excited to be here and honored to be here. And Peter, what do you want to say?
I want to say that this book is amazing. My students were reading Chapter 3 for this week's review, The Corporate Media's War on Reality, which really lays out almost up to date. I mean, we're only a few months out of what they're laying out about the election and Trump's coverage and how that's a news abuse and the massive inequality of coverage in the candidates this year. That chapter is truly an important piece of understanding the America today and the corporate media. Corporate media are the transnational capitalist class. They are the corporate owners. They present stories and top-down news that they use the public relation firms to develop as a propaganda machine to control us, to make us think one way. And it's, you know, pro-capitalism. And I can't say any more than how severe that is in terms of who we are as people. That's Censored 2017, a mind-liberating read that everyone should be involved with. And you can have that for a $120 pledge by calling 1-800-439-5732 online at kpfa.org. We have the Project Censored movie for $100, the award-winning film, or our bumper sticker for $25. We really ask for your support. Mickey was saying how, you know, he and I come down from Sonoma County, 140-mile round trip for me, and, you know, we volunteer. And that's all on our own nickel. And we think it's an important thing to do to be able to talk to people in the Bay Area about these issues. And that's why it's so important to keep KPFA alive, well-funded, and embedded in our culture and our society here.
Indeed, that is. We have 1 minute left in the Project Censored show today. And you heard Peter talking about how much we enjoy this work, and we're honored to do this work, and we love it if you can help us do your part and call 800-439-5732. Get Censored 2017 40th Anniversary Edition for $120 pledge. Mark Crispin Miller has a fantastic foreword for this book. Our free press has a clear and present danger. Why we need Project Censored 40 years later. Again, folks, there's amazing things going on. In the new Censored 2017 book. Be the first to get it. 800-439-5732. 800-439-5732. Peter, thanks so much for joining us on the phone. And we will...
Quick reminder about the Chinese Cultural Revolution, October 1. It's a conference at Sonoma State. Starting at 9:30 in the morning in the Student Union Building, and it's free.
That's right. You can learn more at ProjectCensored.org. I'd love to thank Anthony Fest, our producer, Erica Bridgman at the controls. Learn more about us at ProjectCensored.org. Keep the calls coming and support KPFA. See you next week.